What's up, guys? I'm continuing my ranking of the 10 best songs from the Guardians of the Galaxy franchise. The number I left off with in my last video was number 5, which was Ain't No Mountain High Enough by Marvin Gaye. Number 4, equally as good. These two spots could have easily changed, but I just think this song is just more iconic. And especially like in terms of how it's used in the movie as well. That's gonna be for my number 4 pick, Bring It On Home to Me by Sam Cooke. This is in volume 2, where Quill gets Gamora to dance, kind of breaking down those barriers, and you know, saying that Sam Cooke is one of the greatest Earth singers of all time. And Gamora agrees, and they do a nice romantic dance together. Proving that music is kind of the language of the universe and can even break through the cold heart of a warrior princess like Gamora. So for all those reasons, that's why my number 4 is Sam Cooke, Bring It On Home to Me. For my number 3 pick, I'm going with Fooled Around and Fell in Love by Elvin Bishop.
A million.
Very similar to number 4. It's with Gamora and Quill. Once again, this was the very first time that they danced, and you know, Quill puts the headphones on her and tells her the story of the legendary Kevin Bacon and Footloose, and you know, they sort of hold hands, and then Gamora puts the knife to his throat and says she won't succumb to his pelvic sorcery. So there's all kinds of funny stuff that goes on. Like, it really captures all of what Guardians is, like the humor, the heart, and the romance. My number 2 pick really goes to show how important music is to Quill, because, you know, he gets his ass beaten basically by trying to get his Walkman back, and the song that was playing by the guard was my number 2 pick, Hooked on a Feeling by Blue Swede. Yeah, this is when they first go to prison, and they sort of are, you know, they start off as enemies, very vitriolic relationship when they first meet all of the Guardians. But I really feel like this kind of sets the tone for Quill's taste in music, that he got from his mom, how much that Walkman means to him. He actually goes back for it, you know, once they escape the prison. So, and it's just a fun song, like those loud horns, kind of announcing them to the world. I really, really like this song, so it's my number 2 pick. All right, before I get to my number 1 pick, I did want to shout out a few honorable mentions, because I know there's gonna be people in the comments like, what about this song? You forgot to put this song in. And no, I didn't. It's just, there's so many good songs to choose from. These are just my top 10, you know, that I put together. So these could easily be in your top 10 as well. I really like these, all these I'm about to name. So Space Hog in the Meantime, which plays in the trailer for Guardians 3. Earth, Wind, and Fire, Reasons. Surrender by Cheap Trick. Heat of the Moment. Creep by Radiohead, the acoustic version, which opens up the beginning of Guardians 3. And then Crazy on You by Heart. All great songs that just didn't make the cut this time, and many of them on The Awesome Mix Volume 3 from the third movie. So James Gunn just continues to show how eclectic he is in his music taste. And there's many, many more songs that I know I didn't mention. I mean, even in Volume 3, they play No Sleep Till Brooklyn. That's another one by the Beastie Boys. So I didn't have, you know, enough room. I narrowed it down to 10. That's why there's only 10. So without further ado, here is my number one pick. I mean, I talk about setting the tone at the beginning of the movies with the song choices. This set the tone for the entire franchise of what was to come. You know, Chris Pratt as Peter Quill, it sort of was ominous the way he was introduced. You know, kind of got this Indiana Jones vibe when he's retrieving this orb, this very dark set. And, you know, as soon as he hits the play button on his Walkman and you hear Come and Get Your Love and he's sliding around and dancing and the title pops above his head and you know, he's singing with the little creatures, you kind of you know exactly what type of movie and franchise this is going to be. And I think it's ultimately why Guardians went on to be so successful, is this tone, and a lot of it is because of this song. So number one for me, best song in the Guardians franchise, Come and Get Your Love. All right guys, that's going to do it for me. There you have it, the 10 best songs in the Guardians of the Galaxy franchise. What songs would be in your top 10? Let me know in the comments. Make sure you like and subscribe at @misfit_minded on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, at @actionmoviebuffs on Instagram. Tune into those live shows every Wednesday. And yeah, Guardians 3 review coming soon. Make sure you stay tuned for that, as well as Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. So yeah, look forward to doing more of these, and hope you guys have a good rest of your week.